Hey everyone, just wanted to show you kind of a good alternative to buying a traditional projector screen, whether it be the type that come in a reel and you make your own frame for it, or the pull down type. This, believe it or not, is just a paint on option, and I've had really good luck with it. I debated a long time of what type to get, but since this area down here is kind of our kids' kind of playground area. I hesitated to put a, very expensive screen up. So, again, this here is, it's actually just a wall, drywall that was originally painted this kind of gray color, and I've since painted it this behr silver screen paint. And here I'll show you a picture of the actual paint I used here. Again, it's behr marquee silver screen. There's the information about it. I got it from Home Depot. It's actually remarkably cheap, and I sprayed it on with a little handheld sprayer, but I suppose you could roll it on as well. But by spraying it, I really don't have any lines or kind of weird stripes at all. So when the projector's on, it all looks very smooth. Now some people argue that this is, not nearly as good quality as you get out of the other screens, and they're probably right. But I previously was just projecting on a white drywall and then also the gray drywall, and this is much, much better than both of those options. The contrast is incredible, especially with the projector that I'm using. Now I'll show you the projector I'm using, and that is a an Epson 2150 that I got a couple of years ago. It's a 1080p projector, and we've been really happy with it. Honestly, for light output and overall quality, it's amazing. Now, this screen here is 120 inches from corner to corner. I also have a 20 foot by, I think it's 12 foot tall screen that I use outside as well. And I'll show you another video of that sometime. That's pretty awesome. But I did, again, I painted the actual color, and then around the edges, I got this, it's kind of like a felt tape. Just came in a roll. I think this one's like 3/4 of an inch wide by, I don't know, it came in like a 100-foot roll, and it's adhesive on the one side and just felt on the other. You can kind of see the thickness here, and it went on and kind of makes a nice black border so that if your projector isn't perfectly aligned, it blackens everything out. So a nice thing about it too is, you can fit it up and you can kind of cut around different obstacles and stuff and fit it up exactly where you want it. So overall, it turned out really well. And I'll show you a quick video of it in action. So this is just a quick snapshot of what this projector looks like with full lights on. Obviously, completely still viewable and quite a good screen. And again, these lights, I have a lot of can lights down here, and they're all on full brightness. Now I'll turn the lights off and just kind of show you what it looks like. Well, first dimmed and then completely off. All right, so here's now with the lights kind of in a dimmed, kind of half lit setting, and you can see the colors and everything just completely pop with this screen. It's pretty amazing. And again, this room is still very well lit. You can get around just fine. Now I'll show you with the lights fully off. Now you can see with the lights fully off, I mean, the screen really is incredible in terms of color and overall quality. And again, this is just 1080p, but really, I don't notice any pixelation at all. It's actually incredibly high quality. You got to get up really, really, really close to the screen. Here I am I'm about 4 inches away from the screen. You can start to see the individual pixels. But for us, with an internet connection that isn't always perfectly stellar, and we stream mostly stuff from Roku and play Wii and stuff, the 1080p is more than we ever really need. So, and again, we blow this up on a 12 by 20 foot screen, and honestly, the overall quality is still incredible. So overall, we've been really happy with this setup. Again, it's kind of a DIY, maybe a $50 screen with everything included, and overall, the overall experience is still really remarkable. So I hope you found this helpful, and if you have any questions, please leave them down in the comments. Thanks.